Everyone's heard of Lucy. Lucy is a household name at this point. Lucy shared a lot of information with us about what a bipedal hominin looked like 3 million years ago. But there are other hominin fossils that have been very influential to the public as well as to scientists. One of the most important fossils to ever be found was found by Raymond Dart. It's called the Taung Child, and this is an Australopithecine child that came from South Africa. And it showed us a number of things about Australopithecines that we just were not really ready to grasp when it was found in the 1920s. So it showed us that the Australopithecines were very ape-like and bipedal. And we had a model in mind at that time that humans evolved from something less primitive looking. Another really important fossil is called the Turkana Boy, or the Nariokotome Boy, and he was found in West Turkana. He was probably 12 or 13 years old. This is a really very, very complete Homo erectus individual, and he gave us a window into what Homo erectus looked like. Most of what we know about the body plan of Homo erectus is really coming from this one individual. In 2009, a skeleton called Ardipithecus ramidus was published, and this is a 4.4 million year old hominin. So this is a skeleton even older than Lucy, and potentially even an ancestor of Lucy's species. This skeleton also preserved many different regions of the body and showed us what an even more primitive biped looks like. Hominin fossils were excavated from a cave in Siberia called the Denisovan cave. A finger bone from one individual was sequenced with ancient DNA. In 2010, it was shown to be a new, totally distinct population that is now called the Denisovans. We don't know much about what this species looked like. Almost everything we know about it actually comes from its DNA. And that's because we only have a handful of teeth and fragments of bone. But we know that because they were alongside humans and Neanderthals, they did interbreed with us. First with Neanderthals and then later with modern humans. People in Southeast Asia actually have the highest percentage of Denisovan DNA today. And then more recently, there have been several different partial skeletons of something called Homo naledi. And Homo naledi has been a very exciting fossil species discovery. It's from South Africa, and it's many different individuals, many different body elements, all found in two caves. So it's given us an idea of what a population of individuals look like. So that's also been a very influential recent discovery. These are fossils that continue to inform everything that we know about hominin evolution. There's a lot of questions that are emerging about human evolution. It's still very important to get out and do more field work and find new fossils.